Good morning, class 7th. I'm Mrs. Pooja Gandhi, your art teacher, and today I'm taking a very interesting art class on Madhubani painting. But before we start, let me give you a brief introduction about Madhubani painting. It is actually a folk painting of Bihar, and it is approximately 2,500 years old. It is mainly practiced by the women in villages on special occasions like festivals, childbirth, marriages, and their theme were mostly religious. They depicted god, goddesses, festivals, nature, plants, animals in their paintings. These paintings are done on plastered walls and roofs of the huts with natural dyes. But these days, these paintings are done on canvases, paper, and cloth also. So, Madhubani painting is all about intricate patterns. It is time-consuming art. So, please don't be in a hurry to complete it. So, let's enjoy this beautiful journey of Madhubani painting. For Madhubani painting, you need A3 size cartridge sheet, black OHP marker. For outlining, make sure that you use waterproof marker, violet pen or a gel pen for thin outlining, and for thick outlinings you can use OHP marker, poster color, any one of your choice, paint brushes, take two paint brushes, 0 number and 6 number, 0 number for outlining and 6 number for coloring the background. Now, always start with the border. Border is a very important aspect of Madhubani painting. It makes the painting look complete. So always start with the border. So make 1 inch by 1 inch border on all the four sides of your sheet, the way I have made. See? Now, borders are very simple. I have drawn some borders for you. I'll show you. You can choose any one border for your painting, or you can create your own border as well. These are very simple. Let's see the first border. In first border, I have made the pattern X using X. Theek hai? See. And keeps on repeating it. Draw X and keeps on repeating it. Once this is done, make triangles on both the sides. Fill the outline of these triangles with straight lines like this. And make small circles in the center. It's easy and simple. Now see the second pattern. In this border, draw V horizontally like this. And keeps on repeating it. Once you are through with this, make leaves on these diagonal lines like this. Isn't it simple and interesting? Now, this background we will fill with the horizontal lines. Nice and interesting, isn't it? Now we'll see the third border. In this border, make S pattern. Write S and keep repeating it. Like this. Okay. And now make semicircles on top and bottom part of S. Semicircles on both the sides. On top and bottom part. Now fill the space with vertical lines. Yes. Now this last border. This pattern is made with U shape. Draw U horizontally. Like this. One facing inside, the other facing outside. When you draw U shapes, divide it in two parts. Okay. And now convert these lines in leaves and make a flower. And you can fill the background with diagonal lines. So these are some of the border designs. Now we will start with the painting. So once the border is drawn, your sheet will look like this. Okay. After drawing the border, we will start sketching the main motif in the center. But before we start doing that, let me tell you our main theme is nature. And in nature, I'm giving you 5 motifs. Out of these 5 motifs, you can draw any one according to your choice. These 5 motifs are tree, elephant, fish, sun, and peacock. I'm sharing some references with you based on these motifs in my video. So let's start with the main motif. I'm making a peacock here. You can make any motif of your choice. Now for peacock, let's start with the head. For the head, we will draw a circle. Okay. 2 curved lines. For the neck, 1 drop shaped body, a drop which is upside down like this, the feathers, a long tail. Make sure that you use very light pencil for drawing. Okay, always use HB pencil for drawing. In Madhubani paintings, you always have to draw double lines. And make sure that the lines are close to one another, like this. once the double lines are drawn, divide the body in various sections like this. And fill various geometrical patterns in it, like triangles, circles, U-shaped patterns, semicircles. Vertical lines, triangles. So once the drawing is done, then we will start the outlining with the OHP marker, and your painting will somewhat look like this. This is how your Madhubani painting will look like. Okay, all the thick lines are done with OHP marker. And in order to give some variation in the lines, I have used gel pen, or I use this palette pen also. Some areas you can see are filled with black marker, like these triangles, these semicircles, to give depth in the painting. Now once it is done, we will do the coloring with the poster color. I have done some coloring here, but I'll show you again. The outlining should be done with the zero number paintbrush. Make sure the color does not go inside the motif. Like this. Once the outlining is done, then you can use thick brush. Coloring the background. Thick brush, you can take 4 number or 6 number, but round brushes only. This is how we'll do the background. Seventh standard. I hope you must have enjoyed doing Madhubani painting with me. So see you soon with another interesting art activity. Till then, goodbye.